Mission start.
Thank you.
Mission clear. Mission start. Mission start.
Thank you.
Mission clear. Mission start. Mission clear. Mission start.
How am I doing? I'm all right. Just waiting for all the shit to come out this month. I thought I was going to get my Orochi key today, but seems like they didn't go out to anybody, so probably sometime this week. But I mean, I'm not like super excited for that already. I already put 80 hours into Ultimate. Well, it's like 40 into Vanilla on the Switch, because I had to start from scratch, and then like 40 or 50 into Ultimate. So, I'm playing other stuff right now. I bought this months ago, and I haven't touched it, and they're updating the game soon. Oh. my thoughts on this game are in the title. It's Gundam Breaker with Reverse Combat. That's like all it is. But they're going to be improving the combat in the next update. The next update's supposed to be sometime this month. Better frame rate, worse combat. Gundam Breaker's dead now. I mean, it's a mobile game now. The last game killed the series, so... And these guys are very professional with how they update. They update every week. It's not like one of those early access games where the people take the money and then just rage quit. They just leave, give up. This is made by, like, a really small team. I think it's a pretty impressive game. Melee combat is literally just mashing the button. There's not really anything to it. I'm curious to see how they're going to change it. It's going to be like some kind of transformation to buff. Give you a buff or something, but I don't know how that's going to work. Though, I just hope that they get to that point. I've been burnt on numerous early access games, and this is one I don't feel burnt on, even though the melee combat sucks. They're actually, like, listening to the complaints and stuff, which is a good thing. It's still fun to play, even though the melee combat's bad. I like the customization. I might as well do some grinding now, while nothing is really... I'm not really doing anything big for the channel at the moment. Get ready for it. Early access is just a crapshoot. There's lots of games I've bought that just, like, they just come out of early access randomly because they're not getting enough money. So they just give up and they just stop developing it, which is understandable. It's not fun investing a bunch of money and time into something that's not selling, but I feel like you also have a responsibility to take care of the people who believed in your idea when it was nothing. But unfortunately, that does not always happen. Sometimes you just get screwed over. They don't, like, bother to develop the game. That one Chinese game I played on the channel once, and then they never updated the game again. They just ran off of the money. Literally just rage quit, like, nah, we don't feel like making this game anymore. So long, suckers. GG. Even the people on there were like, that native Chinese speakers were like pissed off, like they just, I looked at the translation, they were like saying that they just take the money and run. Like, yep, they did. Discord? Yeah, I'll give it to you. I'm done with this. Oh, lost weight right now. There's a couple people in there. There's a lot of people that don't talk, but there's people that post news in there for me, which is nice. Saves me some time. And obviously, a lot of the time I have to find all the news and stuff myself. That just takes a long time. Loot pinata.
Mission clear.
That was actually really easy. It's just boring because it takes so long. I guess when I get more gear, he won't be able to tank as much. I could probably do that on hard mode. It would just drive me insane. Snow continues. See if I can get something to increase my physical power, because that's what's making this take so long. So that's all the content in the game right now. Now it's kind of just grind, which is fine. I'm starting to get to the point where I do enjoy playing this. I need 14k for this, and that's a... That's like double physical damage, so I guess I need to farm for that. I should probably ask in the Discord, like, what place you're supposed to go to farm faster, because that's kind of the problem I'm having right now, is that it's just, there's not enough, I don't have enough money to do anything. Yeah, this is the one for melee. Might be some cheap stuff I can get down here that will help. Total attack by 15%, but durability is over 85%. What is the community like? It's pretty small. They're not really advertising the game, they just kind of update it and stuff. It's just kind of sad, because this is one of the better early access games I played in terms of, like, actual communication, and not just trying to waste people's time. But I guess people have been burnt a lot on early access, so I guess they don't want to support it. Which happens. I mean, I don't hate people for doing that. It makes sense. Okay, so... I mostly just need money. I have a ton of materials, it's just the money is what I'm missing. I'm, like, really lacking in cash. I don't think I have anything that will actually give me more damage right now. It's mostly just going to be marginal increases. I cleared that pretty easily though, so that much is good. I'm going to grab this just for survivability. I think you can sell the materials, which I think is something they need to add. I don't see any kind of means to sell it. That would greatly reduce the grinding, because if I could just sell this stuff. But I haven't been able to find a place to do that. I don't even think it's worth messing with this stuff yet until I have more money. Is there anything else I can grab that will help? These ones won't help me. I wonder if you can sell the materials. Maybe there's a place you can go to do that. Yeah, the only thing that's like holding me back right now is the damn money. It just doesn't give me any. I don't see any kind of place to sell materials. I would like to get rid of all that stuff and just, like... They seriously need to let you sell some of this stuff, because it's kind of dumb that I can't. Yeah, I don't think you can sell anything. It's probably something I'll add next patch. I think the melee combat is awful, but they said they've been repeating, like, every single time they update about the game that they're gonna make it better, so I have to believe them. But I think I'll like it a lot more when I have some stuff unlocked, so I'm gonna try to get down this tree. Recover 3% shields while attacking, so that would actually be pretty good. You could just tank. That's kind of what I'm trying to get at right now. Damn, some of this stuff is pretty crazy. A lot of this stuff's like a marginal increase right now, so I don't really see the point. I wonder if I can take hard mode. I might be able to, like, tank hard mode right now. Maybe that's what I need to do. Maybe I just need to move to hard mode, because getting 5,000 credits every 10 minutes, it's gonna take me like half an hour to get one piece. That's a little excessive. Let's try hard mode.
What's up, Claymore?
I did not get my Orochi 4 Ultimate review key yet, so still just playing random stuff. And I've had this game for months. I want to see how many this gives me compared to the other one. Get like 3,000 for doing this in like 3 minutes or something, and I would still be faster than getting 5,000 in 10 minutes. Yeah, they didn't send out the keys today. I talked to my other friends who are in the content creator program, and they didn't get one either, so probably tomorrow or Wednesday or something. It's usually 2 weeks. They usually give us the games like 2 weeks before they come out, but I guess the weekend kind of mucked things up a little bit. They overwork the guy, the social media rep. He has like, he works like the jobs of like 10 people. He has a lot of shit to do. He also is like the voice of us too. Like he talks to the Japanese branch about the mistakes they're making, like ridiculously overpriced DLC and things like that. He definitely watches out for us, but I wish he did not have such a massive workload. That's dumb, man. He's invincible for like a minute straight. I hate stuff like that. What's the point of making them invincible? Just waste time. Question. How much cash am I gonna get for this? Hopefully a lot of money, because 3,000 for 10 minutes is bunk. 3,000 for 3 minutes. Probably would have gotten more. I think you get more if you won CC. Okay, so the next major power increase is going to be this. Because that, like, doubles my attack. So, I guess I'm just going to do that again. So, try BH. See what happens. That's way faster than the other one, though. That's for sure. The only thing that's annoying about this mission is the giant one turns invincible for like a minute and waste time. I don't think you can burst him through that either. It just happens to the time. So I think I want to play a little more safe on the boss and just run away when he turns invincible. Wait for my health to come back. I'm gonna clear out all the mooks first, because they're making me take more damage than I need to be. You don't respawn. points am I, how much money am I gonna get for that? That was very hard, 1 CC. I hope I get an equivalent reward.
Mission clear.
That was about as clean as it'll get. It's just gonna get better once I get better gear. Oh, it like doubled. Alright. Well, this is the way to go then, at least until I get some better stuff. So far, it seems like they don't get a ton of more health on hard mode, on very hard, which is cool. Generally, in video games, it's normally just like, we're just gonna make them, we're just gonna add, like, 3 zeros to their HP, and, there's your hard mode. That was actually quite easy. Okay, so on the next one I should be able to get this, and then from this point I won't have any of the other materials I need, so I'll probably start working on this now.
Mission start.
I don't know if some of these materials are even in the game. I don't know if you can actually get all the way to the end of the tree. We'll have to ask in the Discord. They're telling people to grind while they work on the update, so I assume you can. I don't know. Thank you. Yeah, so I guess he does that at half health. Maybe if you, like, had a super broken character, you could, like, burst him through it. I want to go this tree, actually. Yeah, I think that's probably the best idea. I don't know how much of this shit I have, though. I'm still running with this pretty crappy one right now. I think right now I just mostly need more, oh, I can make this. I'll do that first. I think right now I mostly just need, like, more shield. So that's what allows you to really tank stuff, is, having the shield regen. And since the melee combat has, like, no depth to it at all right now, it's definitely really important that you have that. You don't have, like, extra or properties or anything to really work with, so we pretty much just have to tank things. Is there anything good up here? Okay, so if I do that, like, how many more times? If I do it, like, 7 more times, I can go all the way up to this one. Alright, I guess that's the plan then. I'm not going to do it 7 more times tonight, by the way. I think I'm going to go to bed soon, but this seems like the most efficient for now until I get to the next tier of gear. It's mostly just cutscenes is what makes this take so long. Cutscenes and the waiting. It's not as bad as Orochi, though.
Mission start.
That's way worse than this. Stop after this anyway. I really wish I could sell these materials. That's definitely something they need to add. Like, if the materials don't serve a purpose anymore, if you already have the all the crafting materials to make a piece, you should be able to sell them, or should automatically sell them. That would reduce the grind quite a bit. That's the only thing that's really holding me back right now, is not having money. He's like taking as long as possible. He knows he's gonna die like 3 seconds after he's done with this, so walking over there a little slower than usual. Damn, that little boost, that little blast that comes out after the S-string does like a ton of damage. Build starting to come together.
Mission clear.
There's some other trash over here. Okay, can I craft this actually? Yeah, if I do that one more time, I can craft this. And this in turn will give me a much larger shield than what I have now. It will double the shield capacity. And there's shield recovery up here too, so I think I'm gonna go for that. I'm gonna do that one more time. Pretty imbalanced right now. Ranged is way better than melee. So to kind of get around the discrepancy, you need to have a metric ass ton of like shield and shield recovery.
Mission start.
But apparently the next patch is going to be all about making the melee combat not terrible. So I hope that they'll stay true to their word. They did post an update a couple days ago. It looked pretty cool. It's like some kind of transformation type thing. Able to choose from like four modes, and I guess they have like different buffs they give you or something. Oh, is it not streaming on YouTube right now? That's weird. I must have clicked the wrong button. I had a pretty busy day today, so not entirely busy. Half busy, half lazy. I guess I clicked on the wrong button. Unfortunately, when you alt-tab this game, it crashes, so I can't fix it. If I alt-tab to turn off the stream, or to stream to YouTube as well, then it would crash the game. I don't know why it can't handle being on tab now, but it can't. It's late anyway, I wasn't really expecting anybody to watch. How did he not die? Should still get enough, I think. I don't know if you get more from one CC or not. Asshole.
Mission clear.
Yeah, it does give you less for using a continue. It gave me less that time. Now I have to do it again. How short am I right now? 2,000? Yeah. But I will be able to craft one of these too. I think the best one to get would probably be this one gives more shield, but less shield recovery. I think shield recovery is going to be more important. And then the next one I get is this one on the right here, because this has more shield and recovery. Alright, one more time. They're saying that you need to grind to unlock that transformation. I think they're calling it like quantum mode or something. I wish they would tell me like how far I had to go. I'll like this game a lot more when the combat doesn't suck. But it is a very fun game.
Mission start.
I do like how the cosmetic part of your character does not actually doesn't actually matter for your like combat performance. It doesn't affect your stats at all, which I think is really cool. Gundam Breaker doesn't do that. At least I don't remember. I don't think it does. So you can deck your character out like whatever you want, as long as it's not too heavy, and then it won't affect your stats. So this game doesn't have the problem a lot of other like customization games have, where everybody's running around in like 50-ton armor because it gives the best stats. Oh, have you actually played this game before? If you have, then please help me out. I'm just trying to farm credits right now for the update. Backseat game me all you want, because I couldn't find any information on this game. I'm just trying to upgrade the character. This is the fastest way I found, is it's 6,000 credits on very hard for like 3 minutes of gameplay. It's mostly the money that's holding me back. I don't have any rules about backseating, so if you have any advice, let me know. Hunting ground 2. I'm getting 6k for doing this in Graveyard. Thank you. I hate this stupid invincibility crap he keeps doing. I like when games make the game more difficult by just making you wait. Now I'm gonna get less money for doing this. Stupid fucker hit me.
Mission clear.
No, you get 6,000 if you one CC it. If you die, it reduces how much you get. How far up in this tree can I actually go? Like, is there actually stuff in the game to like craft all this stuff or what? That's what I'm wondering right now. Is they're saying you need to grind to get the new mode for the melee. It's my character's melee. But I don't know exactly like how far up in this tree you can actually go. Tier 4 you can't currently obtain, okay. Well, that makes things a lot easier. So basically, I just need to get all this shit then. Yeah, I just need a ton of money, that's it. Okay, so I would have to do that like 4 more times and then get all the stuff in between. I was worried I had to like grind the whole thing out. So I was like, I get really tired of this. Get really tired of the melee combat, and this is just not fun to me. I'm curious to see how they'll change it, because there's only room for one attack button. Like, how much depth can they actually add? And the current control scheme doesn't really allow it to have much depth. It's not like Gundam Breaker where you have like 2 attack buttons and there's no like active abilities or anything. I think they could do without like having 2 ways to shoot projectiles. I think they should just remove the missile launcher and put it on like an attack modifier or something, and then give you another attack button. I think that would be the best way to fix it. This game is still fun, but the combat is literally is just mashing the button. There's no depth or any like skill involved at all. It's basically just your stats. The missile launcher will be changed. Are they going to add another attack button? So I'm really failing to see like how much more they can really change it the way it is right now. The mechanics don't really allow for it. Yeah, I don't see why that has its own separate button. That should just be like the gun button or something. Well, that would free up an entire button on the controller. Okay, so last thing I need to do is upgrade this, and then I'm pretty much done. I'm gonna put the weapons back on. feel like they designed this game as like a third-person shooter first, and then they did the melee combat like in like the last week of development. As I mean, the shooting controls are very responsive, but for like a game that's supposed to be about customization and stuff, like the other aspect of the game is very lacking. I'm curious, I wish they would talk about like how they're going to change it, because having one attack button is like really limiting. And so much of the controller real estate is taken up by the projectile combat. It feels like they would need to completely like redesign the control scheme. The control scheme in this game is really weird. You have like a huge amount of the buttons on the controller, only for long-range combat. Doesn't feel like they had that in mind when they made like the preliminary build for this. Like, how are they going to expand upon things when it's already just the buttons assignments are heavily weighted towards long-range combat? This is a really cool game though. I mean, Gundam Breaker is pretty much
mission clear.
Dead now. They're making a mobile game out of it. They're not gonna make another console one, because the last one tanked so badly. They just need to get the all aspects of the combat to be more balanced, and they in like both performance and like fun factor, and I think they'll have a really good game on their hands. I think if you just like third-person shooters, then this game's fine the way it is, but if you don't, then it's very lacking. Okay, so the farthest I can go is here, and yeah, I don't have farther to go. I need like another 16,000. Yeah, so I'm all done up here too. It's mostly just the stuff over here. Also, this game doesn't make me sick with its frame rate like Gundam Breaker 3 did. I really enjoyed playing that game, but man, the frame rate was awful. It's like not even 30 FPS. I don't really see how that game's graphics should run that poorly, even on the shitty PS4. I wish they would port that game to Steam. I really had fun playing that game, but performance killed any long-term value it had for me. He's already dead. Almost dead anyway.
Mission clear.
Alright, so I do this 3 more times, then I'm done for real. Because at that point, I'll have, like, pretty much everything. Everything that's currently obtainable with the character I'm trying to play as, anyway. Yeah, it's the last thing to get, is that. So let me go, I'll be right back. I'll do this 3 more times, and then I'm gonna be done for tonight. I was not expecting to be done this quickly. I was under the impression that that entire tech tree was in the game, but I bought this when it came out, I just never really played it, because the combat's just not up to my standards, but I mean, it seems like they're gonna be improving it a lot in the next patch. I was under the impression I was going to have to grind for like a week to finish, but it seems like the only thing I could really do to expedite things would be just grind a bunch of money. I wasn't expecting to get it done in like 2 hours. So I'll be right back. Another like 12 minutes of this, and I'm gonna go to bed. Okay, so if I do it three more times, and then I guess I'll get these, but I'm not gonna do that tonight. So three more of this easy mission.
Start.
clear. Mission start.
Come on, really? Fucker would not die. I hate that stupid invincibility bullshit he keeps doing, just waste time. Lame way to make a boss harder is just make you stand there and wait. And I'm probably gonna have to do it again. Thought I could burst him down.
Mission clear.
Playing DFO. DFO is obsessive with that shit too, just like... just super armor and invincibility phases on everything. Yeah, it barely gave me anything that time. I could sell all this trash it keeps giving me. Why can you not do that? I have like hundreds of these things.
Mission start.
Thank you.
Mission clear.
No, it's giving me less now. I wonder why. That's weird. Why did it only give me 4,000? Does it have like some kind of diminishing returns thing or what? That was a 1cc and it still gave me like nothing. That's fucking pissing me off, man. Why does it keep doing that? It was giving me 6,000 before. Now just randomly just decides it doesn't want to do that anymore. Why? That's stupid. What the hell is causing that to happen? I collected everything. Should give you like more for 1cc'ing, like give you a bonus instead of just the base value.
Mission start.
Wish I could skip all the talking. There's no voice acting. Why do I have to wait? Yeah, it seems like it's got some kind of diminishing return system. Which is kind of weird because the game is currently designed in a way where you can really only spec in one tree. So it's kind of weird that it just decides to give you less money. It's like if you screw up your build or you decide you want to change your playstyle, then it's just more grinding. Real reason. Because those were all 1cc's and it still didn't give me what it was just like a couple minutes ago. Okay, so all this shit up here is not obtainable right now. So I'd have to do this another a couple times. I'm not gonna do that tonight. Yeah, all with a 4 isn't. Well, that didn't take too long. The only thing I really need to do is the slots, but it's giving me like 20% less credits than it was before. So I'm curious where they're going to put the stuff on the tree, because you can't go any farther. Are they going to put it over to the right or something? Because in the architecture tree, there's all this over here. I wonder if they're adding like more branches or something. They can probably easily take a lot of the other missions now. I don't know if they'll give the same amount of money to time ratio as that one does. Even since it started giving me 4,000 instead of 6,000, it's still under 3 minutes now, so I don't know. Anyway. Oh, it'll be an OS thing. Let me see. Yeah, I don't really see where they could put it. Unless they're going to add more missions and allow you to power creep. This game's pretty cool. I definitely believe in their vision, but it's mostly just the gameplay mechanics and the controls is what needs work. I'm curious if they're just going to like rearrange like the button real estate to allow for more melee death. I don't really see how they can do it otherwise. There's no room for like an attack modifier system or anything, so I hope they'll start talking about it soon. I really don't see how they can do it the way the game is currently designed. It seems like they would have to completely revamp everything. The foundation of this seems to just kind of assume that you just want to play like a third-person shooter, so their work's cut out for them, but this game's pretty damn cool. I had fun tonight. I'm done for now. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks for the backseating, Neffy. I really appreciate it. I've never seen anyone here before, but I don't really play games with a lot of story, so I welcome people giving me advice and stuff, especially for something like this where there's barely any information on the internet at all. So I appreciate your help. I mean, they only have like 24 days left in this month, so I imagine probably towards the end of this month they'll drop it. I'm hoping for the best, but like I said, kind of hard for them to change the game drastically the way the controls are currently set up. Anyway, I'll probably grab the rest of those parts in the morning, so I'll see you guys later. Thanks for stopping by.